This, when you first open EndNote, you will see this EndNote 20 new library window pop up. And in this screen, you have two options: to open an existing library or create a new library. Of course, if you're using EndNote for the first time, you will need to select create a new library, and I'll go through that process in a moment. But just some things to be aware of as part of this process. When you create an EndNote library, you're going to be prompted to give it a file name, or you know, select the file name, and also choose the location where you want to save the library. By default, the file name will be My EndNote Library, and you can change this to be something more meaningful to yourself if you wish. We do recommend that when you're saving your library, you create a new folder. And the reason for this is that your EndNote Library consists of two sort of parts, a .enl file and an associated .data folder. The .data folder will store information about records, any groups you have created, and copies of the attached files, such as the PDFs. So keeping all these files in one folder will make it easier to find and back up your library, and it also makes it easier to move it to a different device or to a different sort of save location if you ever need to do that. We also recommend only having one EndNote library. There are features within EndNote that will allow you to organize your references by group as required. So this might be for different assessments or for different research projects. We'll talk a little more about that later on. Another thing to note is that your new library needs to be stored on your computer or in your hard drive, never in the cloud. EndNote is not compatible with cloud-based storage services, including OneDrive, Dropbox, OneNote, iCloud, and Google Drive. So you need to save your EndNote files on the hard drive of your computer, and then you also need to make sure that any documents that you're using EndNote with, so any Word documents that you're using EndNote to create in-text citations and reference lists, those also need to be stored on the hard drive and not in the cloud. Okay, with all that mentioned, let's take a look at actually creating that new library. Okay, so here we are. I have the EndNote program open and it's on that new library screen. So I'm going to select to create a new library. And here's those prompts that I was mentioning. So by default, it wants to call the library My EndNote Library and store it in my documents folder. Just for ease sake, I'm going to add that to the desktop instead. So now that I've selected to save that, okay, so EndNote has launched with the full view now that has a library open. And if we just have a quick look at my desktop, we can see there's that .enl and that .data folder. So that's where you might like to create a new folder to store both of those items within.